It's not every day that you see a Royal Navy plane parked on a lawn in the middle of Somerset, but this one's in trouble. And tonight we see how the pupils of Chilton Cantelo School near Yeovil deal with that problem.
When fire breaks out in
any large building, it can prove quite a problem to put it out. And when that large building's a school, the danger becomes really acute. But here at Chilton Cantelo School near Yeovil, it wouldn't be long before the fire brigade could swing into action, because this school has got its own fire brigade. And right now they're going to show the local fire chief just what they can do.
James, it's very unusual for a school to have a fire brigade. How did it all get started?
We thought that it was something which, an activity which had an end product. I'd myself been a retained fireman in the Norfolk Fire Service for 8 years just after the war. It's a very interesting thing, and it has definitely something for boys, some adventure, some public service. And it's also a lead up to a very good profession.
How extensive is the training that you give the boys?
They cover all aspects of firefighting, breathing apparatus, ladder work, rescue, two girls running a first aid unit who are properly trained in first aid, and use of firemen, the use of foam, getting into buildings, smoke log buildings and so on.
If there were a small local fire, would you be competent to deal with it?
Well, we shouldn't let the house burn down. We should certainly be competent to deal with it, yes.
Have you ever been called out?
We have. There was a small fire, haystack fire, and we went out to that. And we have also had a minor outbreak here outside the buildings, which was dealt with during the night.
Is there not a danger, though, that the boys could get themselves mixed up with a fire which could get out of control and could cause them actual physical harm?
Well, this is always the danger, and this is, of course, why we can't really let them become involved in firefighting in a professional way outside. They know their stuff and they're well trained, but even a professional fireman can run into trouble at any moment.
The Chilton Cantelo Public Schools near Yeovil. They've got an engine and a fire brigade, but they've had no fires at all, no, not a single call. All they do is wear the uniforms and braid. Now a mayor in France, he chanced to hear their story and invited them to help the brigade at Con. Now they're back, they covered themselves with glory. It's hard to believe it's just a week they were gone. When they walked down the street, they looked so debonair. All the people they meet say, "Quel savoir-faire." They sound so elegant, ordering wine. They know it's rape, game of what kind. All the girls that they pass say, a single blaze, and it was in the holiday, and destroyed a derelict pigsty on a farm. 5 years of waiting patiently for fire, never a sign of smoke and never a flame, not so much as a roaring funeral pyre. They jumped at the chance to go to France when it came. When they walked down the street, they looked so debonair. All the people they meet, they guilt of warfare. They sound so elegant, ordering wine. They know which grape came off what vine. All the girls that they pass, say, ooh la la la. They've got that certain je ne sais quoi. What a difference a week on the continent made to the Chilton, Cantelo Public School Fire Brigade. The boys went away to Normandy quite happy. They took the engine uniforms and all. Though they battled many a blaze, their most interesting days were the ones they spent away from the fire hall. They studied the ways and customs continental. They learned the meaning of words like mon amour and other phrases equally sentimental. Now they can't wait to go on another tour. When they walk down the street, they look so debonair. All the people they meet say, quel savoir faire. They sound so elegant, ordering wine. They know which grape came off what vine. All the girls that they pass say, ooh la la la, they've got